In the next minutes, I would like to share with you some of our experience with our new 3 Tesla system that we installed in our hospital in Frankfurt Oder. That is different from Frankfurt Main, who doesn't know. Frankfurt Oder is close to Berlin, the east of Berlin, just to not to mix it. In our hospital, we have a focus on neurovascular diseases. We see a lot of AVM patients, and so our machine, our MR system, should provide a good MR imaging, MRA, to see, to really differentiate in an AVM what is the feeding artery, how many feeding arteries are there, which is the dominant feeding artery, what is about draining veins, are there ectasias, are there any flow-related aneurysms, and so on, just to make a therapy planning in the AVM and just to make it possible see a real indication whether it's embolization necessary or not. In the past, we did a comparison of MR angio, of time of flight images at 1.5 at 3 Tesla. That was a 3 Tesla machine, first generation. Of course, at that time, we could see that the time of flight image at 3 Tesla was much better than at 1.5 Tesla, but it didn't show really the different feeders of an AVM. There was also venous contamination of the image that we couldn't really discriminate what is the AVM, what is inflow, outflow, how fast is the flow. That is years ago. That was published in 2007, so it's long ago. So we look forward to our new system. Maybe it can provide us with other things. This was at the installation at September last year, at the beginning of the installation. At the end of the installation, much better. And so, with the help of God, we started with our new system. I wrote here first results. It's a little bit promising. It's first experience. I will just show you some cases. I will start with a case that is not neurovascular, just to show the capability of the system. This is the time of flight image on the left side and a contrast-enhanced image of the lower extremities. We confirmed the findings of a lot of stenosis, occlusions of arteries with the digital subtraction imaging. We had nearly the same results in DSA than with a time of flight image and the contrast enhanced image. And moreover, if you look to the feet, in the digital subtraction image, you could hardly see the arteries that supply the feet. In the contrast-enhanced image, you have a superimposition of the venous drainage. And only in the time of flight image, the supply of the fluid feed is well shown. So with these images, we look optimistically forward to image the AVMs. We planned that we do MR angio in all AVM patients before and after embolization, just to look whether we can define the most important feeders, whether we can discriminate the venous drainage, intranodal aneurysms, and so on. We did as well a time of flight angio and a contrast enhanced angio with a temporal resolution with less than 1 second per image to have a feeling for the flow and for the flow parameters. Since November last year, we did 17 AVMs in our hospital, but 2 children were excluded and so on, and some organizatory problems in the beginning. We had only MR angios in 7 patients. I will not show you all, only some selected cases. This was one of the first cases, large AVM. This is a venous ectasia, venous stenosis, flow through the middle cerebral artery. All these could be confirmed in the angio, lateral view of the injection in the internal carotid artery. You can see the nidus and this large venous pouch. And after embolizing, only feeders from the middle cerebral artery, it looked nice. Okay, first case. At that time, we couldn't really see what is the feeding artery, what not. This was another case. This patient, 40-year-old male, had bled from this occipital AVM. If you look very closely, you can see some remaining blood in the lateral ventricle. He was well. He was fine. We did a first embolization in September last year. At that time, your lateral view injection in the carotid, internal carotid artery. This is injection in the left vertebral artery. You can see two dominant feeders, one branch of the pericolosal artery, and here's some branches from the posterior circulation. We started in September with the embolization in the posterior circulation, and the patient came back. And at that time, we were not sure whether there is still some contribution by the posterior circulation, or maybe we have only flow through the pericolosal artery. We did this time-of-flight angio, and here we have a dominant pericolosal artery that supplies the AVM, but we had not a feeling for the flow, so we did this contrast-enhanced angio with a temporal resolution of less than a second. This is the acute inflow, the arterial inflow. You can see enhancement of the pericolosal artery, beginning enhancement of the nidus of the AVM, but at that moment, no venous contamination. In the next second, the AVM is completely enhanced by contrast, and the outflow in the straight sinus and deep venous system starts. 2 seconds later, we have a full enhancement of the nidus and the venous system. So after that measurement, we were quite sure that the AVM is supplied predominantly by the pericolosal artery. Could be confirmed by the injection here, the injection in the internal carotid artery with the flow, and we went through these to embolize it. Different case, young female with the pulsatile tinnitus. In the source image of the time of flight angio, you can see here arterial signal surrounding the sigmoid sinus. So this confirmed that it is a dual AVM close to the sigmoid sinus. In the projection, there is an enhancement of the sigmoid sinus and the small artery, but at this point, we couldn't see where the feeding artery, most likely a branch of the occipital artery, possible the ascending pharyngeal artery, maybe branches of the middle cerebral artery. We couldn't see it on this image. So we did, again, this contrast-enhanced fast MRI. In the inflow phase, we had an immediate enhancement of the occipital artery up the back, and immediately the outflow and the venous drainage in the sigmoid sinus. So we saw that it has to be a branch of the occipital artery. In the real angio, this is a selective injection in the occipital artery, in the left occipital artery. You can see here the dominant branch is a retroaulicular branch of the occipital artery. This is super-selective injection into a needle by microcatheter. This was the point from where we embolized this AVM. In the control, here's source image of the time of flight image, no arterial flow around the sigmoid sinus. So the dual AVM was occluded, the patient had no tinnitus and was cured. And we have a good method of control of it. So I can conclude very fast. This fast MRNGO with this time resolution of less than a second turned out to be helpful in the evaluation and in the differentiation of AVMs, and maybe be a good tool in therapy planning in AVMs. There's always no time for improvement, as faster as better for us, but at the moment we are quite happy with this system. Thank you for your attention.